Hey, what's up everybody around the world? Welcome back to another tutorial in Redwest Global Knowledge. Today I'm going to show you how to use mask environment to create any shape in Redwest. Okay, so now before getting started, I would like to ask you, and this is your first time reaching out here and you want to learn more about Redwest, make sure you subscribe button below and turn off for all notification so you won't miss my future tutorial. Okay, I think it's pretty much. Let's switch into our project together. Here I am in Redwest AutoDesk Redwest 2021 interface. So what I'm going to do first, I'm going to our family, then go to new here, then go to English. We going to using our concept zoom mask. So I'm going to using for matrix mask, double click. Once I done that, Redwest will transfer me to another page. Okay, so now I read on mask environment interface. So what we need to do and what curve that we are start creating on our environment, mask environment, we are using start from extrusion until our sphere blank, so you will get more concept to use that. So basically I'm going to create a simple rectangle. First I'm going to start from top there, then go to our rectangle, and of course I will start to using a simple parametric as well. So I will start from here until here, just make it square 15 meter by 15 meter, and of course I need to lock as well. The reason I need to lock that because I want to create a parametric for our rectangle there. But if you want to freestyle to use your extrusion, make sure you don't lock your profile because later on easy for you to adjustment. Once you lock like me, you will be first for only for a parametric only for rectangle only. Okay, here just a thick line only. So how could we transfer to from our rectangle line to our mask? I just select my rectangle here, then go to create form, select form, as you can see here. But I want to add some level on my mask environment first. So how could I do that? I just go to my create tab, then go to my level there, as you can see here, or LL for shortcut key. I just click here, then I will scroll nearby my level here, as you can see here. Now you can adjustment your level there. I will simply add here like this. Just add here 4 meter. And add another one 4 meter. Then I'm going to add another one. Okay. Let's make it a sketch first. I think we add 4 level, 3 level is enough. Okay, once I done my add level, then I'm going to assign 4 parameter for our width and length as well. Then of course I can align my height as well. AL for align, you will start align from level 2 until here. As you can see here, will be alignment. Hit escape a couple of times. Then just simply DI for shortcut key, or you can select your profile there. The trick is our extrusion profile is a different profile. Once you assign for a parametric for width and length for the bottom, so on top you need to assign as well, because in mask environment is a different function from our Redwest family. When you create extrusion for Redwest family, when you create extrusion, you just need to assign one only. But in mask environment, you must be create to a different function for your dimension parameter, as you can see here. So I will show you now. Once I select that, they will show me another dimension here. Then I can select start from here. Then I can press here. As you can see here, it's a square one. Then I'm going to select on top there. I will be at another one. Start create over top here. Okay, let's start from here. Then we select here again. As you can see here, then I can start from here. Sorry. Hit a tab key. Okay. I got two different dimensions. One is bottom and one is top. So how could we assign for parameter? Same as our Redwest family, you just select your dimension here or dimension line there, go to our label, start create a new label for parameter property. Then I will give this one for width, and of course on top one I will make it same as our width. So our value from bottom and top will be the same one we change in our family category there or family property, and there will be assigned for a new material as well. Sorry, not a new material, it's a new parameter dimension. I'm going to make this one is length, and this one will make it same. Okay, perfect. Once I done that, I can change my dimension is a parameter. Let's say I want to make it for 5 meter. Hit apply. As you can see here, then I will make it for 1 meter. Hit apply. As you can see here, it's a parametric and it's locked with our reference line there from mass environment. And here you can create your level by go to create and simply add on. Okay, so now we done our extrusion for our first start. So let me turn this one for 10 meter by 10 meter first. Okay, so now we're working on how to use our void on our mass environment. So what I'm going to do to use void, first thing I need to set a plane first. I will be set here. Then I'm going to create our, let's say I want to create polygon. Then I will make it for 3 side only. Then I can start draw it out like this. Basically, I will start draw like this. Then once I done that, I will select my line there. Go to create, then solid form again. As you can see here, we got only solid form. How could we change to void form? Let me see first. Now I want to cut here. I will be make it until here. And I want to cut here as well. So I'm going to select my void form here. Then change from void form to our, take a look on our property panel. Change from identity data, change from solid to void. So our form here will be changed to void and will be opening, as you can see here. Now you got opening, and of course you can edit profile as well for your void form there. Remember, all the mass environment you can edit profile, either you can create edit here or here, it depend on you. But make sure when you create a parameter, you need to assign a 2 different parameter like me. And if you don't want to create a parameter for your solid form, you just create a simple, just make a simple rectangle here. Let me set our plane first. Okay, you just create a simple rectangle there. Then you just like here, simply create solid form. And now you can play around with that and can create your conceptual building until you got what you want, and only you model in your Revit template. So let me show you first. As you can see here, once I select that, I got another 3 options here. Either I want to going down or I want to make it up. I can play around with that, or I can make it like this, make it about slanted, and I can make here for device surface as well. For assign for a pattern to create our building, you can create your curtain glass here as well. Just apply on that, or you can apply this one with your family curtain panel pattern base or generic curtain panel pattern base, and of course with your adaptive component also. If you want to know how to use that, take a look on my previous tutorial about all you need to know about adaptive component, and I got list down all you can using your mass environment apply with your curtain panel or pattern base to create your pattern. Okay, so here is just a quick instruction for that. Okay, so now once we done that, and of course I can, let me show you more. If I create another circle like this, I can join my form as well. I will create solid form like this. Okay, basically this one you need to relate for, because this one start from another different elevation. I will start from top here, then I'm going to circle again, take a look on placement plan. I'm going to change it to level 1. So now it's accurate already. I will make it like this. Hit escape, select here, then create form, solid form. Okay, as you can see here, and I can move it up until here. Let me move it up first. Okay, then I can join element. As you can see here, now we got two different elements to join together. This is the reason Revit got conceptual mask for easier for architect when he want to create some kind of complex shape or complex project for visualization to propose to his client. Okay, so here I done for those kind of parameter extrusion and void extrusion. Now let's work out for our switch. I think switchboard or you the Revit user they know how to do that, but I prefer to show you guys here also because the tutorial is all you need to know about conceptual mask. Let me create some curve first. Then of course I need to change this one to level 1 and I will start draw here. Just draw it out like this. Okay, here let's get a couple time. As you can see here we got 7 points are different. So how could we use our speak it easier? I will apply a multiple speak here. So I'm going to set a plan, set for vertical here. First thing I will using for triangle here, make it like this. And secondly, I will set again for vertical. I will using another one, same as before, make it like this. Then I'm going to set a plan, set here. Then I'm going to use our triangle again, make it down like this and set again. Set here, are we using for, let's say we use for circle, make it like this. Set again, make another circle again, make it a box bigger and set again. Make it like this. And the last one I will be using for triangle again. We make a different shape. Hit escape a couple of times. Once I done that, how could I create my sweet point here? I just like all like this. I just like here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Then create form, solid form. As you can see here, we got a different option for solid point, but this one not nicely as you saw that. So I just give you a quick concept to apply your switch into your mask environment. Basically you can apply a multiple object and different element to using on your switch, but here not nice. As you can see here, if you want nicely, you just using all your triangle or rectangle or circle will be nicely. Okay, so this one I will hit a Control Z first and I will be delete here. Let me delete this guy over there first. Hit escape first. Select one, delete DE for shortcut key, delete here. Then I'm going to select 3 of this guy there. I think will be better than before. As you can see here. That how you can use your switch on your mask environment. So now what we need to do next, I'm going to show you how to use our revolve on our mask environment. So how to use our revolve? Let's say I want to start from top here, then I'm going to using our model, change our placement plan to our level 1. Then I will start draw like this. If you follow my previous tutorial, you will know what I'm going to do now. Then I'm going to use our arch here, then start here. We'll make it for 10 meters, just make it like this. And make curve like this and make here like this and connect here. Hit escape. Then I'm going to draw another one here, just make it straight like this. Hit escape a couple of times. Okay, let's me delete this one first. Li, then we will make here like this. Hit escape a couple of times. Okay, as you can see here, we got only 2 different thick line. How could we apply this one to revolve? You just like your first profile. I will assuming this one is the first profile and hit Control Z on my keyboard, select another profile, second profile, then just go to create form, solid form. As you can see here, now we got our reward already. It's like some kind of round 1, and of course I can control our reward there. I just like my element here, all my elements, and I will take a look on my property panel there. I got some an angle for controlling my reward there. Let's say I will make it for 45 degrees, then I can just apply. As you can see here, will be hash only. If I apply this one for 180, we will be get another shape. That's how you can apply your reward on your smart environment. So not finished yet, we got our sweet blank. How to use our sweet blank? Basically, our sweet blank I got show here already, so I will give you another quick instruction to get our sweet blank. And the last one, I will using our existing tool here to create our curtain panel here. Sorry, not curtain panel, it's a curtain. So I'm going to start from top here, and then I'm going to use our arts here again. Let's use our sweet and blank. Hit escape first. Then I'm going to our reference, plus point one here, and plus another one here. Hit escape, set a plan, set here like this, and create our circle. Just make it like this, and create another one. Just set a work plan. Make sure you set a work plan for vertical. So I'm going to using for rectangle. Hit escape first. So I'm going to select our first profile and second profile. Create a solid form, as you can see here. And remember, we can edit our profile here. I just click here. Then I can go to edit profile, and I can make this one smaller, and I can hit finish. As you can see here, that's how you can use your form here to create your sweet blank. Okay, for the last thing there, I will show you how to create our curtain, how to create that. First thing, I'm going to start from top view again. Then go to our model, use our spline through point. I just say change this one to level 1, and it will start like this. Just make it like this. Okay, once I done that, I will change from our placement plan to level 1 to level 2. Change to level 2, then I will start draw again. Just draw it out like this. Okay, then for the last guy there, will be same as before, like this, like this. Escape first, then turn to 3D. Okay, then I can select three this guy over there, then just create form, solid form, as you can see here. That's how you can create your simple curtain here. Okay, I think it's pretty much for this mass environment, because I think a lot of my tutorial I got production about mass environment and curtain panel pattern base, or generate curtain panel pattern base, and some kind of adapter component. And it's better it I show you how to use those kind of smart environment to combination with your curtain panel, and that's how you can use your smart environment transfer to next level about how to create any curve for your conceptual mask. Okay guys, I think it's pretty much for this tutorial. I hope you got understand more about that. Thank you for watching, and if you like this tutorial, make sure you hit subscribe button below and turn off for all notification. Thank you for watching, and I see you for another tutorial in Revit, and have a nice day. Thank you.